Srikant Ideal Chemistry. In this video, we are discussing about cement. Cement is an important building material and it is also called as Portland cement. It is produced by combination of lime, silica along with oxides of aluminium, iron and magnesium. If you see the composition of cement, we have 50-60% of calcium oxide, 20-25% of silica or silicon dioxide, and 5-10% of aluminium oxide, and 2-3% of magnesium oxide, and 1-2% of ferric oxide, and 1-2% of sulfur trioxide. So they are the composition of cement. So we will see one by one. So it is an important building material known as Portland cement. So if you see the composition of cement consists of calcium oxide, 50 to 60% silicon dioxide, 20 to 25% aluminium oxide, 5 to 10% magnesium oxide, 2 to 3% ferric oxide, 1 to 2% and sulfur trioxide, 1 to 2%. So this is the composition of cement. For a good quality of cement, the ratio of aluminium and silica should be between of 2.5 to 4 ratio, and the ratio of calcium oxide to total oxide of silica, alumina and iron should be as close to 2 ratio. Once again, listen, for a good quality of cement, the ratio of alumina and silica is in between of 2.5 to 4 and the ratio of calcium and total oxides of silica, alumina and iron should be 2. So, for good quality of cement having ratio of aluminium oxide and silicon dioxide between 2.5 to 4 and ratio of calcium oxide to remaining oxides close to 2 ratio. So this is the best ratio for the good quality of cement. Next, we are seeing about how to prepare the cement, preparation of cement. Okay, the powdered limestone and clay are mixed, and the mixer is heated at about 1770 to 1870 kelvins of temperature. We can prepare the good quality of cement. So the powdered three parts of limestone and one part of clay heated at 1770 to 1870 kelvins of temperature, then we get the good quality of cement. And now I will just give some reactions can be takes place here. So when calcium carbonate undergoes strong heating, it can form the calcium oxide and liberate the carbon dioxide. So these calcium oxide react with the silica and it can form dicalcium silicate. It can form dicalcium silicate. It can write in the other form Ca2SiO4. So it is nearly 26% in the complete composition. Its name is a dicalcium silicate. Dicalcium silicate. And then 3 moles of calcium oxide react with the silicon dioxide. It can form tricalcium silicates. So it can write like Ca3SiO5. Its ratio nearly 51%. So we call as a tricalcium silicate. What is tricalcium silicate? And 3 moles of calcium oxide react with alumina. It can form tricalcium aluminate. So 3CaO.Al2O3, or you can write Ca3Al2O6. It is present in 11%, and it is we call as a tricalcium aluminate. What is tricalcium aluminate? Okay, next
and last equation.
When 4 moles of calcium oxide combined with 1 mole of alumina and 1 mole of ferric oxide, it can give the tetracalcium aluminoferrate. So what is the name? Tetracalcium aluminoferrate. So the other reactions can be takes place in the preparation of cement. So next step here, setting of cement. Next one is the setting of cement. When it is mixed with water, the setting of cement takes place to give the hard mass due to hydration of the molecules of the constants and their rearrangement. So now what we get the substances in the above preparation method, those are mixed with water and allow the settling process of cement takes place to give a hard mass due to the hydration of molecules of the constants and their rearrangement. So in the purpose, adding of gypsum slow down the processing of settling and the cement so that it gets a sufficient hardness. So to avoid to delay the process, we use the gypsum and it is slow down the entire settling process and to give the sufficient hardness. Okay, so this is about the settling of cement. So once you can see, when mixed with water, the setting of cement takes place to give hard mass due to dehydration. Okay, now we add gypsum to slow down setting process to get sufficient hardness. To get sufficient hardness. So this is about setting of cement. And last one is uses of cement. What is uses of cement? So with this we just complete the cement. So use of cement. So The cement can be used in the plastic building industry, and it is used for the construction of tunnels, dams, roads, etc. And it is used in concrete and reinforced concrete. So the cement mainly used in the building industry. So it is used for the construction of tunnels, dams, roads like that. And it is used in the making of concrete or reinforced concrete. So these are the use of cement. So it is used in building industry. At the same time, it is used to prepare concrete and reinforced concrete. Concrete or a reinforced concrete. At the same time, it is used in the construction of tunnels, dams, roads. It is used in construction of dams, roads, and tunnels. So they are the use of a cement. Okay student, this is about the compounds of calcium. In the next video we will discussing about biological importance of magnesium and calcium. With this the topic will be over. Okay students, if you like my concept, please subscribe to my channel. Please like and share my videos. Thank you.